You know our trouble, don't you? We're nothing but a pair of scruffy orphans with no use to anyone but old Shell. And you know what he says, don't you? Efficiency, system, and economy. And don't you forget it. Mr. Edwin Shalford Limited. Edwin Shalford Limited. Shalford. Arthur Kipps. Care of Shalford's Drapery Emporium, Fancy Goods Bazaar, 12 Wood Street, Folkestone. Arthur Kipps. Miss Bates. That's me. Dear Arthur, I've got the evening off. Meet me on the promenade, usual time, usual place. Yours sincerely, Anne. But what about that, Miss Bates? I've got an appointment.
Artie, what do you think you're doing?
I got this letter, Sid.
Never mind about that letter. Here, put your coat on.
Why, what's the time?
4 minutes to go and Carshot's coming.
Carshot's here.
There you go.
Kipps, my heart liver. I never seen such a boy. What Shelford would say, I tremble to think. My heart liver? That's enough of that.
Morning, girls.
Morning, Flo.
Oh, I'm late enough as it is.
He's coming.
Good morning, Mr. Shalford.
Miss Bates.
Yes, Mr. Shalford.
Make curls, Miss Bates. Makes the customers nervous.
Yes, Mr. Shalford.
Pierce.
Yes, Mr. Shalford.
Too much brilliantine, Pierce.
Yes, Mr. Shalford.
Yes, Mr. Shelby.
What's the golden rule?
Customer's always right, sir.
Full marks, Buggins. Brush your coat. Morning. I hear you've been attending meetings. Socialist meetings. And reading newspapers. Socialist newspapers.
My free time is my own.
That's as may be. Don't let me catch you with that bucket of my time. A spray has built in my shop. Is that clear, Pornick?
Perfectly.
I've got my eye on you, Pornick. Kipps.
Mr. Shalford?
What's the secret of successful draper, Kipps?
Efficiency, sir.
What else?
Efficiency, system, and economy, sir.
Don't you forget, especially economy.
No, sir. I won't, sir.
Fat chance I'd get.
9 o'clock, Mr. Carshot?
Turn in second, Mr. Shalford.
Very well. Let the doors be open. Mrs. Walsingham, Mrs. Body.
I'd like to see what you have by way of curtain material. Now I'd like something more satisfactory than the last selection you sold me. Not only did they fade in the sun, but they also seemed to have a fatal fascination for the moth.
Mr. Carshot.
This way, ladies.
We've a new shipment just arrived. I'm sure you'll be delighted with it. One more complaint today, and I'll dock the lot of them. I'm efficiency, system, and economy. And I'm going to get it. I've got my eye on all of
you.
efficiency, system, economy.
They're all the same. Drive you like slaves, then when you get too old to work, they just chuck you away.
Look at old Carshot. He's only hanging on to his job by his eyebrows.
No savings and no pensions.
You find old drapers everywhere. Tramps, beggars, lavatory attendants. We're in a blessed drain pipe. We gotta crawl along until we die.
But it's not always gonna be like this. Shalford's not always gonna push us around.
He does now.
Ah, but then comes the revolution.
I can't wait that long.
Me neither.
But it's no use just sitting and moaning about it.
What else is there to do?
Well, there's a Fabian socialist meeting tonight. We could all join and get up ins and outs.
Him. I'll make a little wax model of him and stick pins.
I'd like to hit him. Hit him right in the evening!
In your bed, Carter! In your bed by 9:30, Pearson. Lights up!
By 9:30.
1 day.
1 day, we'll show him, system.
Efficiency!
System!
Efficiency!
Economy! Us tea, but it's soft and potent, all in the cause of economy. The beer is free, but the beer is water, all in the cause of economy. And as for our comforts, he does his bit. Each night in the basement, he lets us sit by a lovely great fire. Our pay each week is a long time coming, all in the cause of economy.
In winter we perish to save his coal, and even on Sundays he takes his toll.
When he sends us to church to save his soul, all in the cause of economy.
Like a mean old codger, all in the cause of economy.
There ain't no room, but he takes a budget, all in the cause of economy.
And as for his missus, from what is,
she sits all alone there in floods of tears.
Ah, she ain't had a kiss in 40 years.
I'm going on the town.
What about the meeting?
No girls.
Cowards. What about you, Artie?
I'm afraid I've got an appointment. Anyway, I wouldn't be much help.
Oh, yes, you would.
Oh, it's all right for you, Sid. You're educated. I never had no history or anything like that. All we ever learned was geography. And then we couldn't do much, except lists. There was these two maps, you see. One of Africa and one of Wiltshire.
Is that why I'm mucking about with those binoculars? Africa's not that way, you know. No Wiltshire.
No. Actually, I'm looking out for someone.
Who?
Your sister.
Anne?
Well, that's how I got that letter. We've got an appointment.
You're keeping company with my sister, Anne?
Well, no. I mean, it's difficult, you see. We never get the same days off. With her being in domestic service, and me working 7 to 7 at the Emporium. I'd like to have a girl, Sid. A proper girl. But like I say, I can't talk to them.
Oh, you talk to Anne.
Well, but I've known her since we was kids. As long as I've known you. If you've grown up with someone, well, it's different.
Yeah, but Artie, I don't mind girls, but sisters, no. Sisters is rot.
No!
Anne, we was just talking about you.
No, I wasn't meaning you, Anne.
What you mean you wasn't meaning me? I'm the only sister you got.
You want to pick your words better, especially if you want to go into politics.
And if I do, I won't be needing your vote.
It's the only one you're likely to get.
But it's no use talking to you. You never listen.
Fat chance I ever had.
What about it, Artie? You don't want to sit here nattering about nothing, do you?
Well...
Don't you start on him. Anyway, I'd rather natter here than waste my time arguing outside the old fish market.
But it's people like you that deserve to be exploited.
And it's people like you who do the exploiting all over again, given half the chance.
See what I mean? She's irresponsible.
Don't you talk to her like that.
You mind your own business.
Talk to her. Talk to her. It's a waste of time talking to her. She's a traitor to her own class. A traitor to the proletariat. And you're not much better.
Don't you call us names. Go off to your old fish market. We've got better things to do, thank you very much.
Oh, let him go.
That's very nice. Just stand there and let him insult me.
I didn't know what he was talking about. I don't understand all that politics stuff. But I won't have him shouting at you. Anyway, let's not argue. We haven't got all that time.
Well, what did you want to talk about then?
I don't know. Do you remember when we was kids? When I used to come around to your house, and we used to go up to the old lighthouse?
What about it?
It was nice, wasn't it? When we was kids. I mean, I used to like coming around to your house. I didn't have one of my own. And I used to like going out with you. I do like you. I say, Anne, will you be my girl?
I wouldn't mind.
Well, all right then, you are.
Well, what happens now?
Well, we ought to do it regular. Do it proper.
How?
We ought to exchange tokens or something, like a sovereign. Except, I haven't got a sovereign. But I've got a sixpence, and I've managed to file it in half.
Well, what'd you do that for? It's no good if it's broke.
Well, you keep your half, and I'll keep mine. And when we're separated, you look at your half, and I look at mine, and then we think of each other, see? Can I kiss you, Anne?
Don't be silly. Kissing soft. How did you find out about these tokens, then?
I read in the Sunday papers what lovers' tokens are. There's amulets and talismans, like a ring or a lucky star. It says that I'm a sovereign. Sixpences, the only thing I got. Still, half a sixpence is better than half a penny, is better than half a farthing, is better than none. It's a token,
it's a token,
our eternal love.
together, make one. Join together, make one.
Quite enough shopping for today.
Good evening, Mrs. Walsingham. So pleased to be of assistance. Good evening, Miss Walsingham. Mr. Walsingham.
Ah, Shelford, I wonder if I might have a word with you.
Certainly. Kips, the dog!
It's about these evening classes for town hall. Perhaps you've heard of our little venture. The Young Persons Association, don't you know? Good night, miss.
Thank you so much.
Young Persons Association.
Thank you very much. We're anxious to take the working classes off the streets, so we catch them young, send them to evening classes, teach them woodwork and pottery and all that sort of thing.
Very useful.
Very. So we're wondering if you'd like to take a lead here, Shelford.
Me?
You're an enlightened employer. Perhaps some of your apprentices would like to volunteer.
Oh, yes, of course. Weren't they, Kips?
Sir?
Volunteer.
What for?
Woodwork.
What about the shop taking?
It'll keep. This young lad here, Mr. Kips, has just volunteered. Mr. Walsingham.
Splendid! You can start this evening, my sister's class. Miss Walsingham?
She's just matriculated from London University.
Oh, in woodwork?
English literature.
Ask a simple question.
What was that?
I only asked a simple...
You'll attend a class tonight.
Yes, sir.
Tidy up, lock up, then you find your way to...
To the town hall. You'll find the class in the music room.
A willing young lad. But then all my employees are willing. We have a fine relationship in between employer and staff. A father. I treat him just like a father.
Hey, Noddy.
Hi, Noddy.
Thought you were meeting here tonight.
So I was. But after this, I've got to go woodworking.
Go what?
Woodworking. Shelford volunteered me. If you see Ann...
Night, Noddy.
If you see Ann...
Hi, Noddy.
Lucky beggars.
Go, go, go! Go, go!
Am I in time to purchase knickerbockers? Cycling knickerbockers?
We're shut.
Too bad. But I say, you aren't hurt, Randy.
Well, you did give me a bit of an owner in the back.
It's these handles, you know, they're too low. I was coming downhill at rather a walk. Backpedaling for all it was worth. Not that I'm worth much backpedaling.
Well, I suppose accidents will happen.
Rather. Especially when you get me on a bicycle. You've been very decent about it. There's isn't everyone who would take it like you.
Well, anyway, knickerbockers, wasn't it?
Oh, never mind knickerbockers. I feel I ought to make it up to you. I told the old Methuselah might bring the color back.
Old who?
Methuselah whiskey, don't you know? The best there is.
Thanks anyway. But after this, I've got an engagement.
Ah, young lady.
No. Education, actually. Evening classes.
Some other time, then. You took that riff like a gent. The name's Chidlow. Harry to you, Harry to everyone, including Sir Henry.
Sir Henry?
Irving, the governor. Old H.I. Best theatrical manager there is. I'm an actor, you see, and a playwright.
Really?
Not that I've had any done. Oh. Plays, that is. But you just wait and see. You just wait. I got one now, make your hair stand on end.
Well, I'm very pleased to meet you, Mr. Chidlow. I'm Kips.
Cheerio.
Arthur Kips.
Who?
Arthur Kips.
Are you sure? Of
course I'm sure.
Well, blow me down. That's about as thick a coincidence I ever struck. Here, this afternoon, this very afternoon, I put you in a play. The man who kisses the girl in the second act.
I never kissed anybody.
You know what I did? I went down the personal column and every blessed name that seemed to fit my play I took. I don't believe in made-up names. I'm all duller than that. Here we are. It's Arthur Kips, son of Margaret Euphemia Kips.
Yeah, that's me.
Well, blow me down. That's about as thick a coincidence as I ever struck. Outside the last act of the Lion's Mail.
What's the Lion's Mail?
You know, where they catch up with the villain. Nabbed. Nabbed at last. But they shan't have me cheap. Also, Henry, in the greatest role of his career. The bells. I hear nothing.
What?
Tis but a jangling me ears. Ah, he comes.
Where are you going?
To the lime kiln. Ah, I'm there. Into the fire with him. Go into the fire. Look!
Where?
Those little eyes, how he glares at me.
That
was a dream scene.
Well, what's that got to do with my name being in the paper, hmm?
Well, here, read it yourself.
If Arthur Kipps, son of Margaret Euphemia Kipps, born September the 1st, 1880, will communicate with Mrs. Watson and Bean Company solicitors, he may hear something to his advantage.
I don't understand.
What does it mean?
Well, it means, as far as I can make out, that you're gonna strike it rich. You're there, Biff. All you have to do is go down to Watson and Bean and get it.
Get what?
Whatever it is. That's where the joke comes in.
What do you think it is?
Could be anything. It could be a million.
A million for me?
If so, when is old Harry coming, huh? You can invest a quarter share in my play. It'll be a gold mine. Biff!
Well, if you was me,
I'd be running to Watson and Bean like an express train.
But they'll be shut now.
Tomorrow morning, then. I wouldn't waste my time on evening classes. Not this little bit of all right.
Well, what would you do then?
Celebrate.
Already?
No time like the present. And I'll stand you the first little noggin. To Arthur Kipps.
Son of Margaret Euphemia Kipps.
That's me, boy. We're going out, you and I. Our luck's changed. Biff!
Where are we going?
You leave the navigating to Captain Chittilow. He'll steer you all right. To the Hope and Anchor it is.
The Hope and Anchor? I can't go in there. That's a public house.
You're not teetotal, are you, lad?
I don't know. I never tried. But still, one can't always be living like a preacher.
That's me, boy. Come on! Laura, darling. Kipps, this is Laura. Laura, this is Kipps. He's just come into a fortune.
Hello, darling.
Pleased to meet you. I say, she's a bit hot.
She won't bite you.
Is it a lot for fortune?
It's bound to be. They don't throw their money about, these lawyer johnnies. Won't waste a bob on an advertisement. Not unless there's a lot of money somewhere in a little box.
You really think so?
I know so. Old Methuselah, the best there is. Here we are, lad.
Steady on.
Nonsense. Do you the power of good. Here's to fortune.
Cheers.
Here's to the fortune.
Cheers.
All the best.
Party.
Evening.
Friends of yours?
Associates.
Dream capital. Three more then. Enter, gentlemen. We're celebrating your young colleague's success.
Kipps?
He just came into a fortune.
Get out of this. True. Straight up. On the newspaper. Harry, why don't you show him that newspaper? Oh, this is Harry, and that's Laura.
It's true. Look at this.
I say.
How much? Who knows? There's the fun of it.
What would you do, Sid? Would you go?
Of course he would.
Well, I don't believe in inherited riches.
Well, you could always give it away. How about you, Pierce?
Well, first I collect it, then I spend it in about 3 weeks flat.
Good for you.
How about you, Buggins?
Probably some old debt.
But that isn't to his advantage.
They put that in to get hold of him. Often it's wives.
But I'm not married.
Well, I wouldn't touch it, not me.
But what would you do then?
I'd run away and hide.
But suppose it is a fortune.
It's bound to be.
If you had all that money right there in your pocket, what would you buy?
What, right here in my pocket?
Yeah!
I'd buy a banjo.
Me a banjo.
There you go.
Thank you.
The murders he been all this time. It's really too disgraceful. My sister's class will be nearly over.
Then he shan't miss any more of it. I'm watching there myself. I never saved it, you boy. Don't you worry, Mr. Walsingham. Voluntary dinner, voluntary show. Then in the morning, kids, while they're chatting in the morning.
Where's the millionaire?
Who?
Oh, never mind. You'll do.
I say. I'm supposed to preside at a meeting for the League of Fallen Women.
Never mind. You look perfectly respectful to me.
I'm a new recruit for you, Miss Walsingham. This lad here, Kips.
I'm afraid he's rather late.
I know, and I'll apologize for it. I leave him in your care.
Well, Mr. Kips, I don't know where to begin with you. You've missed a whole hour, you see.
I'm very sorry.
But haven't we met before somewhere?
I always open the door for you, Mr. Shalford. I did it for you this evening. Not that you'd remember me.
But of course I remember you now. You're always so polite.
I say.
Always. Now then. What particular handicraft have you decided to practice?
What?
The girls mostly do embroidery, and our Mr. Jones is coming on splendidly with his deck of woodwork. This week he's making a pipe rack.
But, I don't smoke.
Never mind. There must be something you need, something practical for the home.
I haven't got a home, miss.
Oh, you poor boy. Where do you live, then?
At Mr. Shalford's, in the cellar.
Well, then, there must be some little thing that would come in useful down there.
A mouse trap.
Yes, but couldn't you think of something, well, something more aesthetic?
Please, miss.
You've thought of something, Mr. Kipps?
Please, miss, can I leave the room? I don't fare very well. Old Methuselah.
Oh.
Perhaps we could open the door.
I'll open it.
Here, I'll get it. It's no trouble. I'm sorry. I didn't know it would break like that.
But you've cut your wrist.
It's nothing.
He's cut his wrist.
He's bleeding.
Cool.
Please, you must tie it up.
I'm sorry about the window.
Please, please, Mr. Kipps, you must tie it up. Have you got your handkerchief?
Well, no. I haven't got a cold.
Never mind. I have one. It's fairly deep.
I'm really sorry.
It's not the cut so much as the poisoning afterwards.
Of course, I'm quite willing to pay for it.
We must make it as tight as possible to stop the bleeding.
Whatever you think best.
Could you put your finger in the knot, dear?
Sure.
There, there, that ought to do. Is it hurting?
No.
I'm sure it must hurt.
No, really, it doesn't. I'm only sorry about the window.
Nonsense. But I'm afraid you won't be able to do any more woodworking tonight.
Oh, I'd still like to go on with the class.
No, I think I've done quite enough for one evening. We'll leave it to next class. That'll be all for tonight, ladies and gentlemen. We'll meet next week.
Good night, Miss Walsingham.
Good night. Good night,
Arthur Kipps?
Arthur. And wash that wrist as soon as you get home.
She's nice.
isn't she?
I'll say.
She's gonna do what she said, the more said, woof, or mortified.
Otherwise, you'll have to have it sawn off.
Sawn off. Good night.
You smell that handkerchief?
Eh?
Go on, smell it.
Perfume.
Nice, isn't it? And she called you dear. Lucky beggar. And I've been here for 3 months. She never called me dear. But then I've never cut my wrist.
Kips, I met Miss Walsingham and she left town off. She told me all about you breaking a pane of glass, about cutting your wrist. And do you know what, Kips? She suggested I give you a day off. Before you know who we are, I'll be popping up every hour with a hot water bottle serving roast chicken and brandy. You liked that, wouldn't you, Kips?
Yes, sir. Very much, sir.
Well, you're not going to get it. Any of it. Day off, roast chicken, brandy, nothing.
He was really mad.
Why didn't you tell him about the fortune?
It doesn't seem so certain now. I mean, Buggins may be right. It could mean more trouble.
I'm sure it would. It never does to hang with those lawyers. They're parasites.
Once you get mixed up with the law, you're never free of it.
Aren't you even going to write them?
No, it's all a mistake.
You're right, Artie. Best to forget about it.
And I can't think straight anyhow. My wrist hurts, and me head. Oh, and me tummy.
Good morning. How can I help you, miss? Why, it's Ian Pornick, isn't it? That's right. I don't want to buy anything. I just want to talk to Artie.
You'd be lucky.
He can't talk to anybody. He's off sick,
down there with his arm in a sling.
He's a fat head.
A what?
An hangover.
Never. Not my Artie. He don't drink.
You should have smelled him this morning.
You don't look too good yourself, Anne.
I caught a cold in my head waiting last night on the promenade for Artie. 3 hours I waited.
Well, I don't like to tell tales, but she was wasting your time.
He was out with an actor.
I think it's disgusting and that fancy Miss Walsingham. Not nice. Not nice at all. Philandering.
I don't
shut up as well.
Romeo, fruit!
Oh, you stay away from me. You've got me into enough trouble as it is. Hand my wrist, Terrence. Hand me hand.
Nonsense! News below from Rialto! Good news!
Keep quiet.
I've come post-haste from Watson and Bean.
The lawyers?
Exactly. And very civil they were.
And?
We're in! Biff! Just like that! A fortune!
A fortune? How much?
£1,200, sire. £1,200 a year!
But...
Sharp! Sharp! What's up?
Passed out at the news.
What news?
£1,200.
Get out!
£1,200 a year!
Get out of this.
The truth, went to the lawyer myself.
What's up?
It's Kipps.
And left a fortune.
Go on.
£1,200.
How much?
Do stand back, give him a chance.
Oh, cold should have won. That heart attack dropped dead from the shock. Good old Kipps.
Well, I'll be blown.
He's coming around. Quiet, quiet.
He won't live to enjoy it.
I say, 1,200. 1,200 a year. Blimey.
You ought to stand champagne.
Champagne all round.
All right, champagne all round.
What are you going to do with the money, Artie?
Travel. Go to Paris. Then French will have it off in no time.
If I were him, I'd go to the Rockies and shoot bears.
No, London. London is the only place for a man about town.
But what about the shop? Hang the shop.
Hang the what?
I said hang the shop and hang old shop.
All right, all right. I warned you. I told you. I said one more time and that is it. Well, that is it. You're dumb, though, Kipps. You're sacked.
I am I?
You are. And no fortnight's notice or any of that rigmarole. You're out here and now.
Watch it, Shalford.
What?
I said, you just watch it. You can't sack me. You know why? Because I just resigned. Here and now. This minute. Resign. So you act civil and respectable, well, you'll find you're the one with the sack. I've just come into a fortune I have. 12. How much was it, Chidlow?
£100 a year.
£1,200, Shalford. A year, Shalford. So I can buy you out before you can say efficiency. I don't like the way this place is run. So wake yourself up, or you'll find you're the one with the sack. Efficiency, Shalford. And back to your blessed economy. I've been waiting to say that to him. He had it coming every step of the way.
Good old Kipps.
You should have seen old Shalford's face.
I thought he was going to throw a fit.
£1,200 a year.
Good old Kipps.
Good old Kipps.
Be a mighty dog.
And see the world. America, France, Russia, Egypt, Tunbridge Wells.
He can go anywhere, anywhere he chooses, we can go.
I'm gonna buy presents for everyone. For Pierce, a silver walking stick with a solid knob. For Buggins, a meerschaum pipe. And for Sid, the completed works of Karl Marx.
He can buy anything, anything he can. Thank you.
lie in bed till 10:30 every morning, and then breakfast, fried eggs, 4 rashers, bubble and squeak, and the whole pot of bloated paste. That's for real living.
Oh, yes, much more. Though, it's funny, you know. I'd rather miss the shop now and then.
You're bound to find everything a bit strange at first, even lonely.
Yes, that's why I'm sorry I can't go on with that class.
Well, just try to do something else to make up for it. How about dinner with us tonight this week?
Well, I'd like that very much.
Mama?
But of course. Shall we say Thursday?
Yes, let's.
Shall we say 7?
Anytime you like.
Here's the address.
My son has many excellent collections in London. One of his friends is the son of the Lord Mayor.
Well, thank you very much. Goodbye.
Bye then.
Oh, I almost forgot.
Forgot what?
To congratulate you. Believe me, Alpha, I'm delighted for you. And don't be lonely.
Oh, I will. Till Thursday. Goodbye, Miss Helen.
That's better. Au revoir.
Miss Helen Walsingham, Bachelor of Arts.
That's the one thing I know. She's too far above me to kiss somehow. A kiss, she'd say. What's this, she'd say. Then go off with her head up in the air. Yeah, she's too far. She's too far.
inferior.
But for instance, you don't think of me as an equal, like.
Why not?
Well, if I thought, you're so educated, London University and all that.
That's nothing.
Well, I should think I was no end of a swell if I did.
But those things don't always matter. The fact is, I'm a disappointed person, Arthur. Folkestone, you know, is a seaside resort, and it values people by sheer vulgar prosperity. We are not prosperous, and we live on a street that is no longer fashionable. We have to live there because it's our house. It's the only thing we own. It's a mercy we haven't to let. I've been to London University, but what good has it done? I still feel discontented.
But I believe you could do anything you wanted to if you tried.
And so could you.
Perhaps, without
help.
Help.
You can do anything.
Hello! Oh, Lord.
It's only some young people on bicycles.
You're sure? There was someone else used to come around here. Someone I used to know.
Hello!
I must go anyway. Mama will be wondering what happened to me.
Oh, don't go. Please don't go. I must talk to you. I've got something to ask you.
Not now.
Then I'll come with you then.
No, truly, Arthur. I'd like to be alone.
To think and all that?
Yes, but don't worry. Tomorrow night, there's the regatta on the old military canal. You're coming with me, of course. We've been invited to join Mrs. Bloody's houseboat party. And with the lanterns and the moonlight, it'll be nicer. To talk, that is.
But supposing it was to come on to rain?
Hush, Arthur, dear. For I feel I know so much more about you now. I knew you the most generous and modest of men. And now I know you are the most understanding. And Arthur, don't worry, it won't rain.
If the rain's got to fall, let it fall on Wednesday, Tuesday, Monday, any day but Sunday. Sunday is the day when it's got to be fine, 'cause that's when I'm meeting my girl. If the rain's got to fall, let it fall on Maidstone, Oxford, Oakston, any place but Folkestone. Folkestone's the place where it's got to be fine, 'cause that's where I'm meeting my girl. What could be weather or temper than to sit on a picnic camper, sipping a sarsaparilla underneath a leaky umbrella? If the rain's got to fall, let it fall on Thursday, Saturday, Friday, any day but my day. My day's the day when it's got to be fine, 'cause that's when I'm with my girl. If the rain's got to fall, let it fall.
who's here.
Oh, look at Arnie.
He looks like an Arnie.
How goes it?
We've been running to you. We're going on our holidays next week.
Oh.
Well, we're off to the continent.
Are you going to Boulogne?
Oh, parlez-vous français?
Strolling down the boulevard.
Comment allez-vous ce soir?
We're both coming with us.
You can afford it.
Oh, I'd like to, but,
Ah, Kipps, here you are. Oh, you're with friends.
Oh, don't worry about it. You're Mr. Watson, aren't you?
I think we had better join our party, damn cheek. Helen.
Oh, I'm sorry. Come on, guys.
Appa, where have you been?
Oh, I'm sorry. A slight accident. The cabbie lost his way, so I had to leave him at the bridge and run along the towpath.
That's nearly a mile.
I know, but I didn't care. I didn't want to be late for our appointment.
Oh, Arthur.
And you're all pleased to see me, after all that thinking, I mean.
Of course I am.
And is it all right, then?
Of course it is.
Promise.
I promise.
And you really will?
I really will what?
Will you marry me, Helen?
Yes, Arthur. I will marry you.
Woo! I say, hurrah!
What's going on?
Congratulations! You're going to be a brother-in-law. She's going to marry me.
Splendid!
Oh, no. Not rain.
It'll pass over. Mother, we must spread the glad tidings.
It's getting nearer.
You hang on to me. I'll see you all right.
Dear Arthur, you're so understanding.
Happy, Ellen?
Wonderfully.
You say that now, but you'll see. I don't know things. I'm not good enough. I'm not refined.
But I'm going to help you.
You'll have to help me in fearful luck.
But all these things that trouble you are very little things. If you don't mind, if you will let me tell you things.
I wish you would.
Then I will.
They're little things to you, but they're not to me.
All right. For instance, your pronunciation, you don't mind me telling you.
No.
There's H's.
I know. I've been told.
It only requires a little care.
I dare say I'll soon get into it.
And then there's dress. You don't mind.
No.
You must never be too dressy. It makes you look like a shop assistant. A well-off common person. It requires a sort of ease. A real gentleman looks right without looking as if he had tried to be right.
Just as though he put on what came first?
Not exactly. More of a sort of ease.
I will do my best.
I know you will.
Come on now, Kipps, old man. This is no time to hang about.
What's up?
We can't find the bubbly.
You can't? Well, I did order it, like you said.
Did you now? You had better drink it up before the rain comes and spoils it.
Perhaps it's down below in the galley. That wretched maid's probably forgotten to open the case.
I'll go and see.
Drat that girl.
They're all the same these days.
She'll have to go. Garment off these last few weeks. Love or something. She's just not up to the work anymore. Walks around all day with a kind of amazed expression. Pretty, of course, but then there's no occasion for a parlourmaid to be pretty.
None whatever. But then my wretches are plain enough and big enough, heaven knows. And do they work? Not a bit of it.
The passions of the common domestic.
The bubbly's here.
And about time, too.
Artie?
Oh, Lord.
Artie, what are you doing here?
Artie, how dare you speak so familiarly to my fiancé?
Your what?
My fiancé.
You're going to marry him?
In 6 weeks' time.
My Artie?
Yours.
He's mine.
If you let me explain.
You'd better explain, and you'd better explain quick. Tell her you're not a fiancé.
But,
You're not, are you?
Well, it's quite simple.
Are you?
Well, we are engaged.
You slanderer! You told me you loved me. You give me your token. Well, you better have it back. You can stick it together and buy yourself another Sunday paper. I don't ever want to see you again.
And
just keep off. Just keep off, that's all. You, Artie. Well.
And
Arthur, please. Will you bring me in? I think it's beginning to rain.
Any day but Sunday.
this vulgar behavior.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And straighten your tie. And do try not to perspire so when you dance. It's really not polite.
Isn't it?
Certainly not. A gentleman reveals neither effort nor emotion when he is trying to enjoy himself. You must remember, Arthur, that you're about to marry a waltzian. And we are connected to the Beaupré's, Lord Beaupré.
Only distantly.
Nevertheless, connected.
A lord? God knight.
Please use expressions like that, Arthur. Really, you are impossible.
Come now, Helen, dear. Difficult, maybe, but not impossible. I can already see an improvement in him, faint but promising. I feel our little conversations together are beginning to bear fruit.
Oh, they are, Willie. And how very good of you to take the time.
And you still have the book Mrs. Bodding gave you, Arthur?
The Art of Conversation?
Yes.
I'm finding it very odd.
Hard.
Hard?
You must work at it.
I'll do my best.
I think we all need some air. We'd like a turn around the garden before tea. The delphinia are lovely in the moonlight.
Splendid.
That would be very delicious.
I adore delphinia. Arthur?
Just coming.
You rang me up? Oh, it's you again.
I had to talk to you. I wrote you a letter.
I tore it up. Anyway, you're not supposed to talk to me. You're a guest and I'm only the parlourmaid.
But I wanted to explain things.
I told you to keep off.
Oh, but everything happened so quickly. You don't come into 1,200 a year every day. It takes you a bit by surprise.
It took me by surprise when I found out you was engaged to be married.
I suppose it did.
You bet it did. Anyway, I hope you'll be very happy.
I don't feel very happy.
Me neither.
You've been crying, Anne.
Only for about 6 weeks. But what's it to you?
Yeah. Why don't you have a good blow?
Arthur! Oh, there you are, Corny. We want our tea. Oh, would you prefer lemonade?
Thank you. Tea will do very well.
Oh, what would you like, Mr. Walsingham?
A whiskey and soda. Lemonade.
Then that'll be tea before. A lemonade. No, whatever is it, girl? Not sniveling again. You must pull yourself together and stand up straight when I'm talking to you.
I thought you were going to dismiss her after her terrible behavior at the regatta.
So I was, my dear. But then they're so hard to find these days. So I changed my mind. I kept her in the last 3.5 days to remind her of her place.
I think you've been too lenient, even charitable.
Now, just a minute. What's all this stopping in and keeping money?
Nothing to do with you, Arthur.
Well, it's got everything to do with me. Anne, is this true? Has this one been knocking you about?
Oh, Artie.
Well, have you?
Of course not. I was simply trying to teach her a lesson. For her own good.
You'll keep out of this, Ellen.
I most certainly will not keep out of this. You'll apologize to Mrs. Bodding, and then you will apologize to me. Is this how you repay my mother's kindness, my brother's efforts, and my own weeks of struggle?
But what about Anne's weeks of struggle?
What about Anne's weeks of struggle? You are engaged to me.
I have heard just about enough. We tried to do something with you, make something of you, and what have you done in return? I am appalled. You are never, do you hear me? Never to see or speak to that common little person again. We set out to reform you, and reform you we shall.
Now, just a minute. What's all this common little persons? Who's a common little person?
She is that wretched little servant girl.
She's not wretched. She's Anne.
She's not Anne. She's a housemaid.
I don't care what she is. You people talk about her as if she was something different. As if she was a monkey in the zoo. Common persons. Well, I'm one of them. I like them. And I like her. Come to think of it, I like her a whole lot better than what I like you.
Arthur.
And I'm gonna tell her so.
But what about me?
I'm sorry, Ellen. You'll have to manage on your own.
But the wedding.
It's off.
Young man!
So. Don't you stop, Mrs. One more boat praise and kippers out of you. So help me, I'll belt you. Good afternoon and good day, Miss Walston.
Well.
say I'm not surprised. He just had it, got it in him.
No gentleman, and never will be.
Once a draper, always a draper. Why, Helen, whatever is it? Dear, you're crying.
Yes.
For him?
Yes, for him. Don't you understand? I loved him, and I loved him just the way he was.
I've been engaged. I want to be married to you, now.
What do you mean?
I mean, come away and marry me before anyone else does.
But I can't. Anyway, my month's been up for more than 3 weeks yet.
Well, then ask to go.
She wouldn't let me.
Who wouldn't?
Mrs. Body wouldn't.
Well, then come without asking.
She'd keep my things.
She won't.
She would.
Who cares? I'll buy you 100 things.
It wouldn't be fair on her.
What is an error you've got to think about? It's me.
You didn't think of me. You haven't treated me very proper.
I never said I had. I'm all wrong, Anne, and I never said I wasn't. I got myself all tied up with everyone and made a fool of myself all around. I didn't know what I wanted, so I went and behaved like a fool, just as anyone might. I know what I want and what I don't want now, Anne.
Well?
Well, will you come? Will you come? If you don't answer me, Anne, I'm desperate. If you don't answer me now, I'll go right out now. I haven't a friend in the world. I've gone and thrown everything away up there. Everything. I don't know why I've done things and why I haven't. All I know is nothing matters in the world anymore. Nothing. I might as well chuck myself in the sea.
Artie, don't drown yourself. Not yet. Oh, Artie, don't go. Don't go.
I've been so miserable, Anne. I've been so miserable.
Mind you, I wouldn't do this for everyone.
I do love you, Anne.
And I love you too, Artie. I suppose I always have.
Goodbye. The ground at last is
on young Walsham about that. He's somewhere about.
Pinching bridesmaids, I shouldn't wonder. Why'd you have to go and ask him?
I had to. He's my financial advisor, ain't he?
Well, what about your domestic plans?
He's going to open a shop.
Your old trade, Mr. Kipps?
No, nothing like that. He's going to open a bookshop. Aren't you, Artie?
I wouldn't mind. One day, there's no real rush. I got to build an house first, then look around a bit. There's no hurry.
Smile, please. Everybody smile. You too, sir.
I am smiling.
Right you are. Oh, just like that. One more picture.
All lined up in a wedding group, here we are for a photograph. All dressed up in a morning suit, and we're trying not to lie. Sincerely came man in his first, took a trip to Gretna Green. There's always been a photographer to record the happy scene.
One more picture. Hold it.
The same thing happened long ago as crime. And what went on, we only know from the snaps they took at the time. When Adam and Eve in their birthday suit decided to get wet. As Adam was about to chase the fruit, the man with the camera said, "Hold it, flashbang, wanna put a picture, click, wanna picture, wanna photograph." Poor old Dean, there was nothing on face or red in the big leaf.
Bump, rockin', skip, 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 skip,
tried to climb the orchid wall to reach his lady fair. As he tumbled, he began to fall. As he traveled through the air. Ho! Flashbang, wanna put a picture, what a picture, what a photograph. Poor old chap, what a night he spent. Tights all torn and his rape kept back.
Rockin', skip, 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 what a picture, what a picture, run to me up, bum, 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 bum.
Had several wives, including Anne Boleyn, and he kept an album of their lives with all their photos in. As Anne Boleyn was on her knees, dressed in her very best frock, King Henry shouted, "Smile there, please," as her head rolled off the block. Oh, flashbang, what a picture, Nick, what a picture, what a photograph. Comes the prince in a little while, lost her head, but she kept a smile. Napoleon married Josephine, that was just the same to do. And he galloped home from the battle scene, all the way from Waterloo. And as he came from off his horse to the boudoir where she sat, she said to him, in French of course, as he took off his big cart hat. Oh, flashbang, what a funny picture, click, what a picture, what a photograph. There she was, with the beagle's arm, all caught up in a rebel-la-la.
Picture,
one picture, run to the up, 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 up.
Sing the family,
sing the family, sing the family,
sing the family,
ever.
does you any good.
Oh, no, not socialism. Not today.
Nor any day, I'm beginning to think. Nobody knows where they are anymore. Look at Pierce. Look at young Walsingham. Where's the difference?
Oh, come on, Sid. It's supposed to be a wedding, not a funeral.
The world's all in the topple. Another few years and they'll all be in it.
In what?
Universal confusion. You wait. Wait for the lean years.
I've never known anything else, but Ann and I don't have to worry anymore. He's a gentleman now.
Bad lot of good it'll do him.
Sid!
Well, a man in my position...
I think it looks silly.
It makes me look older, more respectable. That way when I go see my lawyers or discuss the new house with Wilkins, it helps me.
By the time old Wilkins finishes building the blessed thing, you'll have a beard down to your
knees. The Afternoon Post, ma'am. Shall I clear away?
Not yet. Artie hasn't... Mr. Kipps hasn't finished his rhubarb. She gives me the creeps, that girl.
You don't have to say that I haven't finished my rhubarb. It's enough to say, not yet. You're too apologetic with her. You've got to remember, she's supposed to be working for you.
And I'd rather do the work myself.
Unavoidably prevented from seeing you today.
Who is?
That young Walsingham. I like his cheek, after I give him his start and everything.
Who's the other card from?
Dashed if I can read a word of it. I can barely make out shitlow at the end. It's like someone in a fit writing. I suppose he's either done something or not done something towards starting that new play of his.
What about that 200 you gave him for a quarter share of it?
Probably gone on old Methuselah.
I expect that's about it.
I can't read the rest no how. Wonder what I should do this afternoon.
Go for a walk, I suppose.
I've been for a walk this morning. I wonder why it is he won't see me.
Oh.
Young Walsingham, suppose I'll go see Wilkins about the new house.
About those 11 bedrooms?
I do wish you'd leave me alone about those blessed bedrooms. You don't understand, do you? But you soon come around to my way of thinking. I'll build a palace for my girl. I'll build a palace made of emeralds and pearls. Twice as big as the Albert Hall. High as the Eiffel Tower is tall. I'll build a palace for my girl. I'll build a coach house for my bride. I'm gonna build a coach house for a coach in which you'll ride. You'll go by with a team of blacks, jingling harness upon their backs. I'll build a coach house for my bride. You'll have a garden full of flowers. You'll have a garden in which to walk round takes 2 hours. Water hall to improve the view, twice as wet as the one to cure. You'll have a garden full of flowers. I'll build a bedroom for my bride. I'll build a bedroom with a bed that's nice and wide. Wide enough for a coach and pair, twice as bright as the Belle of Ware. I'll build a coach house for my bride. I'll build a tower for my girl. I'll build a tower with the flags all on the row. How the way when your birthday comes, all saloon with a row of trumps. I'll build a tower for my girl.
No!
I only want to have a little house. A sensible. A little house, a villa in a street.
kitchen has to have 11 bedrooms. Walsingham says so, and Wilkins says so.
And Walsingham's having you, and Wilkins having you. And what's more, they're laughing at you.
I'm going out. Where are the plans?
Where they always are. There as they always are, in the blessed way.
What's these?
What's what?
These calling cards.
It's callers.
Ms. Porritt Smith. Ms. Mabel Porritt Smith. Mrs. G. Porritt Smith. The Reverend Porritt Smith. Reverend? Lord, clergy?
There was a lady and two grown-up girls, all dressed up, and the little chap dodging around behind them.
Oh, what do they want?
I didn't let them in.
You didn't what?
No, they didn't come in at all. I answered the door on the floor. How was I to think about callers, Artie? We ain't ever had callers all the time we've been here.
Well, where was Gwendolyn?
Out for a breath of fresh air.
God, I wouldn't have had that happen. Happened for £5, clergyman and all. You did ought to have known better than that, Anne. You really did.
Well, I don't see it's any use getting into a state about it now.
Don't you? I do. Here's these people. Good people. Wants to associate with us. Instead, you go and slap him in the face.
I didn't slap him in the face.
Well, as good as. But there's only one thing for it.
What?
Return the call.
How?
How? Take them a card.
How can I?
How can you? You've got to.
No.
You've got to, and you must.
I can't, and I won't. Anything in reason I'll do, but face those people again, I can't. After what's happened, I can't.
You won't?
No.
So there they go, off, and we never see them again. And so it goes on. We don't know nobody, and we shan't know nobody. And you won't put yourself out, not a little bit. I'll take the time to find out how it ought to be done.
I never ought to have married you, Artie. It's true, I never ought to have married you. I'm not equal to the position.
Well, you can try, can't you? Look at me. I've improved. Why can't you? Instead of which you go enameling floors and sending out the servant, and when visitors come...
How is I to know about your old visitors?
Well, you ought to have done. I'm going to see about those bedrooms.
I don't want 11 bedrooms!
You have 11 bedrooms and like them!
With the money we got and the books he reads and the high-born folk he knows and the clergy calling and all, we're gentle folk now, I suppose. Something's wrong when we don't agree. Something's wrong, and it ain't because of me. I know what I am. I was brought up in a simple way.
Who's here?
How good?
part of town.
Looking for you fellas? Thought we might have a night out. Have a drink or something. On me, of course.
It'll have to be on you. We're all pretty broke.
Oh, don't you worry about that.
Where's Ann?
At home.
She all right?
Of course she's all right.
Is she happy?
Of course she's happy. Why shouldn't she be?
Well, if anyone should know you ought to, you've had a chance to sample two sorts of society. So you tell me.
Look, I haven't quite gone into it yet, all right?
Too busy spending all his money.
No, but it's funny, really. People seem to think that there's a place somewhere that's always safe and happy. But it's just not true.
Look, I didn't come around here to stand and talk about happiness. I set a night out like old times. So what do you say?
Leave it on, McDuff.
To the Hope and Anchor it is first, then off to see my new house. Come on. Well, how do you like it?
Well, it's not quite started yet.
It's gonna have 11 bedrooms.
And sleep 22 families.
But when it's done, it'll be the poshest house in Folkestone. And when I have my housewarming party, every important person you can think of will be there. Just you wait and see.
Yeah, but what are we celebrating tonight?
Anything you like. Come on, I've had a rough day. And I was counting on you to cheer me up.
All right, let's make it a party.
Come on, enjoy yourselves. The party's on the house. The party's on the house.
Thank you.
said he was prevented.
Then I think you better read this letter.
A letter for me?
God. Whatever is it?
No wonder he's prevented.
Who?
Young Walton.
Why?
Because he's gone.
What for?
For his health.
What do you mean?
I mean he's gone. I'm like 24,000 with him. Is that right, Miss Ellen?
I'm afraid so.
He's been speculating. He speculated every penny we had. Now he's run off.
You mean we ain't got nothing left?
Not a penny. Not a blooming penny. He's bought things there and sold them cheap. We played hanky panky with everything we had.
All these terrible accusations against my son must be proven in a court of law.
If they ever catch him.
Sorry, old man. But I always knew it wouldn't do you any good. Tough luck, Arnie. I'd like to help out, but I'm a bit short myself at the moment.
It's the system, Arnie. It's not your fault. It's nobody's fault. It's the system. The world's all in the trouble.
I've been a fool, Ann. Perhaps you'd better go and stay with Sid till I think things all out.
Here, I'm married to deny. I'm staying, I am. And maybe it's not so bad as you think. Even if we only have a little left.
I don't want things to be so marvelous for you. A big house and pretty clothes and things.
I didn't want all that, Artie. I only wanted you. And I got you, didn't I? And ain't nobody gonna speculate that. But at least we both still have October.
Half a sixpence is better than half a penny. Is better than half a farthing. Is better than none. It's a token.
Twopence apiece, all in the cause of economy.
Merry Christmas, Anne. Worst weather we've had in years.
Shh. Don't wake the babies.
Well, we have a surprise for you.
I've had enough surprises, thank you very much. I don't like surprises.
This one's all right.
A great, big, roaring, tremendous winner. I had to tell you. I had to tell you. I had to tell somebody. I had to astonish somebody. Been up all night talking with the boys. I'm a bit off at this now. But it knocked them. It knocked everybody. Biff, Biz, Curtain, Knockout. They called for the author. They called for the author. I went on. It sounded like walking in Niagara Falls. Couldn't say a word. Loved like a baby. They even laughed at that.
Well, I just think you have to stay quiet for a bit.
No, I couldn't sit still for anyone or do it for you. It's you I'm thinking of. You and Arthur. It means wealth. It means money. Here's a check. First advance from the management. And it's for you, Kip's old pal. First return your quarter share.
Oh, but Chidlow.
And there'll be more, thousands more. We're fair, square, in. Biff!
Oh. Chidlow, about this money? I really don't want money.
Nonsense, it's yours. You invested, so you jolly well keep it. And a happy Christmas and a prosperous new year to you all. Who's coming down for the tour of the old Methuselah? Mrs. Kipps?
No, thanks all the same. But baby.
We'll celebrate by myself.
Then. We'll celebrate with you then.
Splendid. Farewell, dear heart. We must needs be gone. Come, kiss me, Kate.
Is he all right?
It's right side up as a billiard ball. Down a day or two, more money. We're really in this time, Kipps.
Faith in money after the things I've seen.
Anything,
I'm sorry. I was just thinking what a rum go everything is.
Funny.
Hey, now, I don't suppose there ever was a fella quite like me before.
Thank you.